In 21 years, she's taken an active part in helping women and children and also raising funds and donations. She's a gorgeous soul, and she's the one who actually got the Freedom Parade and, you know, helped us spread awareness on HIV. Please put it. She doesn't need an introduction, does she? She's pretty. She's gorgeous. She's Aji. It's been 21 years, long journey with Mukti Foundation. How has the journey been so far?
The journey is definitely very interesting. I was doing my social work before also, but yes, I formed my foundation 21 years back. My first activity was for AIDS awareness, because at that time, people were really not very known about what the disease called AIDS is. There was a lot of taboo about this particular disease. So me being into the film industry, I have taken help from film fraternity, then cricketers, then industrialists, and then a lot of big events just to spread louder message. We have done like 11 episodes TV program also, along with HIV infected students, as well as women, as well as men. My only intention is to take help of entertainment industry, is to show that life is beautiful and we can spread the message positively. So this time also, we thought of doing something different. Now that people know, people are really aware of what AIDS is. There are a lot of developments in medical platform also. There are a lot of new medicines which have come, where you really need not have to get scared. It is just like other diseases. And we thought of taking an advantage of joining a different community. So I thought of joining hands with LGBT people also. There is, when you see the statistics, there are different kinds of ratios which are showing, which are increasing and decreasing in women, in LGBT people, than in straight people. So we thought like we would like to join hands with all the people and give message in a very colorful way. So this is how we thought, and today's day, the parade is here, and beautiful people here, and beautiful people around me. So I'm so thankful that people have been really supporting for what I really want to do in my society.
Just one question related to your parade. You know, AIDS is a very serious topic across the world. What thought did you have to come, you know, with an idea of having a parade with it?
Like I said, we have only one life, and I believe in that you should live your life fullest. So to give the message that I love my life, each one love their life, and please accept all those people who have been detected in HIV. You cannot just ignore them, you cannot ill-treat them, and each one has right to live their life. So we chose this concept like a parade. To love your life, to see it very positively. This is what my intention is, to choose this.
Thank you so much. Thank you for all the awareness that you have shared with us. And yes, we want to hear from Sunny. Sunny, as a person, as a human being, what is it that you do to spread awareness on HIV?
Well, I promote condoms. So there's the first one. I believe that education starts from home. Education starts from events like this that get held by amazing foundations. I believe that everybody has a voice now. Everybody's on YouTube. Everybody has a social media account. And if all of us just come together and spread the word together, then we can make a really, really big difference in the future of young people and in, you know, educating people on what they can do and how to bring awareness to each other. So it's really important.
Sunny, one question. You know, it's still like a social stigma of the fact that people still bother about the fact that, oh, I have to go and do an AIDS test. Do you think everybody should do an AIDS test?
Absolutely. I think that if you are promiscuous and you are, you know, engaging in acts before marriage, that, you know, even if you are getting married, I think it's a good idea to go get tested. You don't know where the other person's been. So as far as I'm concerned, I think it's extremely important to go get tested, not only for HIV, but for other STDs that are out there. It's not going to hurt you. It's just a little tiny prick. And then once you get that piece of paper that says that you're clear and everything's negative, you'll feel amazing. This is something that is practiced a lot in the US, and I believe that there are plenty of facilities that don't judge you, and you can walk in and you can get tested, and you don't have to worry about anything anymore. So I believe it's extremely important. If we all say, let's get tested all together, then maybe it won't be so uncomfortable.
That is so true. Please give it up for Sunny, guys. What a lovely message. Get tested. That is important. Know where you're at so at least we can, you know, continue with our medications, or at least you know you're free from it. Talking about other STD infections, like Sunny just mentioned, you're the best in telling us about it. Now, we've heard about HIV, but there are other, you know, names like ART and ARV. What are those? Can you just explain?
So ART and ARV is antiretroviral or antiretroviral therapy. And these are very effective medications for HIV/AIDS. Like 20 years back, the epidemic looked different because the medications were expensive, they were inaccessible, they had a lot of side effects. But thanks to the entire science boom in this field, we really have effective ART, so much so that HIV is now like any other chronic manageable disease, you know, just like blood pressure or hypertension. You have the disease, you don't get cured of it, but you live your entire life taking effective pills. So that's the protection for the person who has the disease. What's also important is that people who have HIV and are on these medications suppress their virus in their blood. And once the virus is suppressed, they do not transmit the infection. So there's this entire concept of undetectable. By undetectable, it's the virus being undetectable in blood. These people are untransmittable. So by just getting everyone diagnosed, so say if I go for a test, I get diagnosed with HIV, it's a shock. I mean, we have to agree it's a shock. But it's also a shock because there's so much stigma around it. So I think we need to make it, as a society, more acceptable that, okay, fine, that's HIV. It's just another disease which is manageable. So if I test positive, I can still live a normal life, be on medications, and also take care of my kids, my partners, that they don't get infected. And if I do get negative, we need to be aware that we have a lot of options, you know. Condom was the only thing up till now. But now we have something called as post-exposure prophylaxis or pre-exposure prophylaxis. And these are HIV medications that are given to HIV negative individuals. So either before sex, so that's pre-exposure prophylaxis, or within 72 hours after sex, which is post-exposure prophylaxis. And these medications are effective. I mean, they can just protect you from HIV. The only thing that we need to remember is that these medications protect us only against HIV. So these are only adjuncts to condoms. Condoms cannot be replaced. So if one needs protection from all sexually transmitted diseases, condoms, and PEP and PrEP for HIV.
A request from Smitaji, if you could say whatever you said right now in Hindi as well, please.
तो आज के तारीख में एचआईवी ऐसी बीमारी हो गई है जिससे मरने की ज़रूरत नहीं है या डरने की ज़रूरत नहीं है जैसे ब्लड प्रेशर है जैसे डायबिटीज़ है वो बीमारी पूरी तरीके से जाती नहीं है, पर आप गोलियां लेते रहो, आपकी बीमारी कंट्रोल में रखते रहो और आप जीते रहोगे। HIV वैसी ही बीमारी हो गई है, उसकी जो दवाइयां हैं वो उपलब्ध है, वो ऐसी बहुत महंगी नहीं है, उनके साइड इफ़ेक्ट्स नहीं है और बहुत इफ़ेक्टिव है। तो आज की तारीख में जो इन्फेक्ट हो रहे हैं और जिनको दवाइयाँ मिल रही है वो अपनी एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल ज़िंदगी जी रहे हैं, उनके सब कुछ नॉर्मल होता है। उनको बच्चे हो सकते हैं, जो बच्चे नेगेटिव होंगे अगर वो शादी करते हैं तो अगर उनका वायरस सप्रेस्ड होता है इन दवाइयों पे, तो वो अपनी बीमारी एक अपने नेगेटिव पार्टनर को भी नहीं देते। तो सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है टेस्ट करवाइए, क्योंकि अगर टेस्ट ही नहीं करेंगे तो ये सब रास्ते ही नहीं खुलेंगे। अगर पॉजिटिव है तो दवाइयाँ हैं, अगर नेगेटिव है तो कॉन्डम है, वो सबको ही पता है। पर अब कुछ दवाइयाँ हैं जो उपलब्ध है, जिन्हें बोलते हैं प्री एक्सपोजर प्रोफिलैक्सिस या पोस्ट एक्सपोजर प्रोफिलैक्सिस। आपने सुना होगा प्रेप या पेप। तो ये दवाइयाँ ऐसे लोगों को दी जाती है जो HIV नेगेटिव है, पर जिनका संबंध ऐसे लोगों से आ सकता है जिनका स्टेटस या तो उनको पता नहीं या तो HIV पॉजिटिव है। तो ये दवाइयाँ या तो सेक्स से पहले या तो सेक्स से 72 घंटे के अंदर लेना होता है, और ये दवाइयाँ इफ़ेक्टिव है। तो ज़रूरी है कि आपके पास ये इन्फॉर्मेशन हो, आप ये इन्फॉर्मेशन अपने बच्चों को दे, अपने दोस्तों को दे, अपने भाई बहनों को दे, क्योंकि ये सब ऑप्शंस है। तो जो जो इन्फेक्टेड नहीं है उनको इन्फेक्ट होने की ज़रूरत नहीं है।
और एक बात यह कहना चाहती हूँ कि हम लोग किसी को अगर कैंसर हुआ है तो हम उसको थोड़े से ओ गॉड उसको कैंसर हुआ है, पर जहाँ किसी के बारे में अगर ये सुनाई देता है कि ही और शी इज़ बिन HIV पॉजिटिव हुआ है, तो उसकी तरफ हमारा नज़रिया, मिस सोसाइटी का नज़रिया इस तरह होता है कि इसने ऐसी गलती की है तो इसको सज़ा मिलनी चाहिए। ये जो एटीट्यूड है वो हमको बदलना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि सेक्सुअल ट्रांसमिटेड सिर्फ HIV नहीं होता। कई बार होता है कि जो गलत सुइयां लगाने से भी HIV हो सकता है, वो स्प्रेड हो सकता है, फिर औरतों को अपने मर्दों से हो सकता है, और कई बार डायरेक्ट ब्लड कॉन्टैक्ट से हो सकता है। तो कई बार गलतियां भी होती है मर्दों से, हम अपने लोगों से कई गलतियां होती है तो उनको तो माफ़ करते ही है ना। तो आप उसको उस नज़र से क्यों देखना चाहते हैं कि जिनको HIV हुआ है कि उन्होंने बहुत बड़ी गलती की है, और गलतियां होती रहती है ज़िंदगी में, उसको सुधारना और अपने लोग अगर उसको अपनाएं तो उसको सुधारने में उसको दिक्कत नहीं होती है। तो कहने का मतलब ये है कि पहले तो आप डरो मत, क्योंकि डर के आगे जीत है, ये तो हर किसी को पता है। तो अगर टेस्ट करते रहोगे तो ये डर हमेशा के लिए कायम उसको नेस्तनाबूद कर सकते हैं हम लोग। बस यही हमारा एक मैसेज मैं देना चाहती हूँ, और मैं इतनी खुशनसीब हूँ कि हर कोई ये मुद्दे को बहुत अच्छी तरह से जानने लगे हैं, और हमारे देश में उसका रेशो भी नीचे जा रहा है। पर कई बार अभी आज के टाइम्स में ये है कि प्रेगनेंसी औरतों को ज़्यादातर 208 में वो 8 लाख थी, पर अभी 218 में 21 लाख उसका नंबर हो चुका है। तो ये बहुत शर्मनाक चीज़ है। तो मैं मर्दों को भी यही कहना चाहूँगी कि क्या आप अपने औरत को ये डिज़ीज़ आप ट्रांसफ़र करना चाहोगे, या अपना बच्चा इस तरह से पैदा होते हुए देखोगे? ये उसके अलावा अगर आप टेस्ट करते रहोगे और आप दवाइयाँ लेते रहोगे तो ये दिक्कत नहीं आएगी, और ये सामना आपको नहीं करना पड़ेगा। बस यही मैं इतना कह के मैं आपकी तरफ से थैंक यू कहना चाहूँगी। थैंक यू, सॉरी मैं बहुत कुछ बोल गई।
थैंक यू सो मच। यू नो आई नो फॉर द फैक्ट दैट देयर इज अ कम्युनिटी डाउन देयर, फ्रेंड्स डाउन देयर फ्रॉम द LGBT टीम हु आर एंग्शियसली वेटिंग फॉर यू सनी। And I was speaking to one of them, her name is Anjali, and Anjali was telling me that there's still a social stigma, although the Section 377 has been abolished. And there's a lot of connection that people tend to put between HIV and the LGBT community, which is false. What do you have to say about that?
First of all, to the gay and lesbian community, I'm so happy that you guys are here. whoever is here. I think that this is not, I believe it's not a choice. I do believe that you're born a certain way, you feel a certain way, and you have every right to express yourself the way that you want and love who you want. Love doesn't know gender. Love doesn't know if you're a boy or a girl. It doesn't matter. And I'm so happy that you all are here today. And as far as HIV goes and AIDS, I think that, yes, it is a stigma. There are so many different ways that you can, get this disease. So just educate yourself a little bit if you don't know how this disease gets contracted. And, I'm really happy and proud to be here. I love the gay and lesbian community. All my best friends are gay or lesbian, so I love it. I'm very proud of you for being who you are and who you want to be. If you want to dress like a woman, dress like a woman. If you want to dress like a man, dress like a man. If you want to love a man or you want to love a woman and it's the same sex, then love is just love. And I'm very proud of everything that's happened. And this law being passed, I'm so happy. So gay pride.
Thank you so much. I have one question to doctor, and then I'm going to go to Rahul. Just last two questions. Doctor, when somebody is tested HIV positive, what is the next step they need to do?
So if they're tested HIV positive, the next step is to find yourself a qualified doctor. And these doctors are available both in the government and the private sector. Do not fall prey to quacks. You know, there are a lot of people out there who claim that they will cure HIV. That doesn't happen. HIV cannot be cured. So if someone says that kuch dawaiyan le lo, HIV negative ho jaoge, aise nahi hoga. So find yourself a good doctor. There are a lot of medications for you out there. And just be confident, it's just a matter of a few days that you get over that test result and then you know the right direction. And once you're on your medications, that report is just a piece of paper and life is back to normal. एक बार अगर आपका रिपोर्ट पॉजिटिव आता है तो सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है कि आप सही डॉक्टर के पास पहुँचे और ये डॉक्टर्स दोनों सरकारी अस्पताल में भी है और प्राइवेट अस्पतालों में भी है आप ऐसे डॉक्टर्स या जो अपने आप को डॉक्टर बोलते हैं जो लोग जो ऐसे बोलते हैं कि हम HIV को पूरा ख़त्म कर पाएंगे ऐसे डॉक्टर्स के पास नहीं पहुँचे ऐसे नहीं होता है एक बार आप सही जगह पहुँच गए तो आपके लिए दवाइयाँ हैं HIV के लिए काफ़ी दवाइयाँ हैं जो महंगी नहीं हैं सरकारी अस्पताल में तो ये फ्री में भी मिलती है और ये दवाइयाँ इफ़ेक्टिव है आपकी लाइफ एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल होगी सिर्फ एक पीस ऑफ पेपर पे जैसा रिपोर्ट होता है पॉजिटिव वैसा होगा बाकी और लाइफ विल बी बैक टू नॉर्मल
थैंक यू सो मच एंड माई लास्ट क्वेश्चन टू राहुल राहुल यू बीन ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द मुक्ति फाउंडेशन वी वुड लव टू हियर योर मैसेज फॉर द यंगस्टर्स आउट देयर फॉर टुवर्ड्स द अवेयरनेस ऑन HIV
As I said during the beginning or the opening of this program, I have just about a few years ago joined Mukti Foundation, and this was not something that was sort of levied on me. This was something that I did by choice. And now I have the support, of course, of my mom because I've been following in her footsteps. But now I have my wife, Aditi, joining in as well. And this is something that we are doing by choice because I feel that we as the youth have not just the responsibility, but as the youth, we have a drive that we want to do something for our society because we are the society, right? We are the ones who are making that change. We are the ones who are actually bringing that slight shift day in and day out, inch by inch, every day. So I think when it comes down to the acceptance of someone who's different than us, whether it's the LGBTQ community or whether it's someone who has a disease that we might not completely understand, it is up to us whether we choose to push someone away or bring them close to us and accept them as part of one larger community or choose to stay in a mindset which is still closed and still segregated. I mean, we can still stick to moral policing, but it's better off. We are stronger if we are united, and we are stronger if it's a much larger crowd, like the way we are right here today. So I think that's the responsibility we have as the youth, and that's what we should do. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Please put your hands together for our amazing panel and all the information and education that they've shared with us on HIV. And may I request you to come forward just for a group picture, and then we have Ansh who's going to perform for us.
First of all, let me thank all of you. Thank you, press. Thank you, Sunny. In such a contribution of her. I would also like to thank Nikhil Ruparel.